What is it that keeps you away from the church? At the top of the list, inevitably, is I think the church is full of hypocrites. And we've heard it over and over and over again. The church is full of hypocrites. I don't want to go there. There's a bunch of hypocrites. I was thinking about what Jesus said in Luke chapter 12 when he's talking to his disciples and he says to them, "Beware of the leaven of the Pharisees, which is hypocrisy. Nothing is covered up that will not be revealed or hidden that will not be known." It seems like Jesus had a really big problem with hypocrisy too. I did a study on that word and it's really interesting. In the ancient world, a hypocrite was someone who was an actor. It was even used in the realm of theater, you know, someone who wore a mask. And that's exactly what hypocrisy is, isn't it? It's wearing a mask, trying to conceal.
Exactly. The Lord hates the proud, but is near to those who are of a broken and contrite spirit. I think a lot of times we think God doesn't know. You know, God doesn't really know our hearts. So we pretend. We even wear a mask to God.
Yeah.
And we pretend. That's self-righteousness. Wearing that mask, that was the Pharisees, their mask of self-righteousness. But inwardly, Jesus said they were full of hypocrisy and looked good on the outside, but on the inside, full of death.
They were unwilling to come to Jesus. I mean, that was the biggest problem is not that they were just sinners, but that they weren't willing to admit that they were sinners and go to Jesus. Mm-hmm. And that's always—
Absolutely. When somebody says that I don't need to ask for forgiveness because I have a great relationship with God, God despises that response.
Yeah.
That is because you're basically saying, I don't need the Son you gave for my sins. I don't need to acknowledge that. God hates that self-righteousness. God hates that hypocrisy. But the person who cries out, you know, the prostitute, the drug addict, the doctor, the lawyer, the respectable citizen, supposedly, who has really botched up their life, and they come to the end of their rope and they look up and they say, God, be merciful to me, a sinner. God just absolutely embraces that person in love.